Welcome back, RAMCO administrators. In this session, we're going to talk about how to export from your system into Excel, update the records in Excel, and then import those changes back into the system to make a whole lot of updates in RAMCO all at one time. Now, this technique can be used for any type of record in the system. The main thing that you first need to know how to do is to use Advanced Find or your filters to get down to just the records that you want to export. It's okay if you can't get exactly the records you want to export, because you can always update just the records you want to update once you get your data into Excel. Let's take this from the approach of updating a number of member subclasses on our membership records. Let's navigate over to membership. And here's our list of memberships in the system. And let's say that we need to fill in some holes in the data. We'll add some member subclasses to any realtor memberships that are missing one. So I'll go ahead and turn on my filters, and I'm going to filter down just to subclasses that don't contain data. And then we'll filter down just to the realtor member type. All right, so now we've got just the records that we want to export to our Excel file, and we're going to update these and then import them back in. Let's go ahead and export this data to Excel, and we'll open it up in Excel. And the columns that are going to be in your Excel file are going to be the exact same columns that you had on your Advanced Find. So whatever columns you have displayed here, that's what's going to be in your Excel file. If you need to have different columns, then you're going to need to go into Advanced Find and add or remove columns using that tool. All right, let's go ahead and just make our updates. I'm just going to say that all of these memberships need a subclass of R, so I'll just put that in, copy it down the list. Anything else that I needed to update here, I could certainly do that, including statuses, including license numbers, dates, anything else. Now, you'll notice something special about this file. This file starts on column D, and that's because there are actually three hidden columns in this file that contain the unique mapping information for the records I exported. So when I import this file back in, I'm not actually going to have to tell the system which column on my file matches to which column in the database, and I'm not going to have to tell it which records I want to actually update, because all of that is contained in those hidden columns. All right, so if you're going to be updating these existing records with this technique, make sure that you do not do anything with those first three hidden columns, because that would break all of that mapping information. All right, we've made our updates. We're going to go ahead and save this. And we want to keep the same file type, so we'll just keep it as an Excel workbook. And then we can close our file. And back in the RAMCO system, we'll go to the workplace, and then we'll go to data management. From here, we can navigate to the imports section, and we'll go ahead and use the icon right here to import our data. All right, let's pick our file, and we'll move to the next step. Now, if you've seen the previous tutorial on how to import to add records, you'll notice that the import wizard just skipped a whole lot of steps. And that's because all of that mapping information, the file types, all of the key values, all of that's contained already in the file that we exported from the system. And we didn't change any of that. We just made updates to what we wanted to change. So the system can bypass all of that because it already knows it. We'll go ahead and submit this import and finish. And then we can refresh our view until our import starts processing. And then it will update those records. So we'll give it a moment. All right, now it's started importing. Let's refresh again. And you see it's imported 10 updates out of 15 so far. And now it has completed. So let's go ahead and double click on our import file, and we can open it up and see which membership records were fully imported. And now all of these membership records, which previously did not have a value for the member subclass, now all have the value that we input on the file. And it's really as simple as that. Using this technique, you can update 10, 100, 1,000 records all at the same time. We do, however, ask that if you're going to be updating any type of record that synchronizes with nerds, such as a contact record, a membership record, account record, and you're going to be doing a whole lot of updates, more than a few hundred, that you contact the support team and let us coordinate that with you, because every time you make a change to your RAMCO database that then triggers an update to nerds, that puts that change into the nerds queue. And if it's a change that doesn't necessarily need to go to nerds, then we could do that in a different way so that we don't trigger many, many hundreds of nerds updates that would needlessly clog up the queue. All right. Hopefully this is helpful. Of course, if you have any questions or want some additional advice on how to do imports to update records, please post a thread in the RAMCO user community, and another user or one of our team will do our best to assist. And thank you for your time on this session. We'll talk to you next time.